In this video, I'm going to be going over a simple way to develop your own blitzes in Madden 21, get pressure on the quarterback, and talk a little bit more about defense. What's up, guys? My name's Cody, and I want to thank you for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. If this is your first time visiting my channel is all about helping people become the best Madden players they could possibly be through sharing with you offensive and defensive tips and tricks every single day on YouTube. And so if you have not hit the subscribe button yet, I want to encourage you to hit that subscribe button at the bottom right hand corner of your screen. It is completely free to subscribe, and it allows you to stay up to date whenever we release new videos right here on the channel. All right, guys, so in today's video, we're talking a little bit about defense. Now, I've been asking you guys some questions on the community posts, and I really appreciate you engaging with those. If you haven't seen some of the community posts, go ahead and check that out over there at my channel on my community page. There's some polls and different things, just trying to get some feedback from you guys about what are some of the videos that I've made that have actually really helped you. And so one of the pieces of feedback that you guys gave me was that you want to see a little bit more defensive tutorials. And so I've been doing a deep dive into defense over the last month and just really wrestling a little bit with some defensive tips and strategies. And so I'm excited to share with you a very universal tip. This is something that you can apply to almost any formation. I'm going to share it with you from two specific formations today. One of those is an ebook that I'm actually getting ready to release this weekend on the Big Nickel over G. The other one is on the Nickel 335 wide. Now, in my personal opinion, the 335 wide is the best defense in the entire game. It gives you everything that you need from a defensive perspective and the ability to stop the run, stop the pass, and blitz, as well as play match coverage, zone drops, and great man-to-man coverage. So if you want to get my full Nickel 335 wide defensive guide, I'm going to leave a link to that in the description of this video. But again, today we're talking about 335 wide. We don't have to make any adjustments, but for my personal just OCD, I'm going to go ahead and sub in a safety here at the middle linebacker position. You don't have to do that, but it just allows you to have the best personnel possible. So we're going to talk about developing your own blitzes today, and we're going to first focus on just kind of the meta. We know from research that the majority of people in Madden 21 are either going to be running gun bunch or trips tight end. One of those two formations is what you're probably going to see. So today we're going to be working against the trips tight end. And what we're going to do is we're just going to come out in a simple, we'll just pick like Tampa 2, okay? And we know, you know, obviously we want to press coverage so that we can make every defense look the same. That's one of the things that I've talked about a lot. But if you take a look closely at the center and guard, you're going to see that they have these little shadows underneath them. That's to indicate different types of block resistance. So when you're talking about user rushing, which would be if I were to take Green and just run him through the A-gap, then basically what's going to happen is these are the linemen that he's going to engage with. The reason this is a valuable tool and resource is it really gives you clarity on where you need to kind of hover in the gap so that you can occupy the offensive lineman so that you can get the blitz to come in. This year in Madden 21, I tried personally to make it so that you didn't have to hover in gaps to get pressure. You don't really have to hover as much as people probably think you do, but you do have to occupy offensive linemen. This has been something that is true of Madden for years, and it's the same thing here. So all I'm going to simply do here is try to get a five-man pressure to come, or a four-man pressure to come in. So what I'm going to do is, you see here, if I move Green, if I move him to the left a little bit, you're going to see that those shadows will change. Now it shows the tackle and the guard. If I move him to the right, you're going to see it now moves. You see how it can kind of move based off of where you stand. An example here is, as you can see here, I'm occupying the center and the guard. So wherever I want the free runner to come off of, it really does come down to where do I stand on the line of scrimmage. If I shift the defensive line, you're going to see that it also is going to shift. As you can see here, I can do something like this. So the reason I'm saying that is, if I was trying to develop a four-man pressure, I might want to do something like shifting my line to the left, crashing my line out, and then basically occupying this angle right here with my user. So I'm going to put my user on a blitz, and as you can see, it's going to occupy these two guys. So with the snap of the ball, the goal is to basically get that pressure to come in off the left edge. Right there, we got a little bit of a free runner, but the offensive lineman did slide over to kind of pick it up. And so that's where you need to wrestle with should you send an additional player. One of the things about blitzing is that it's very experimental. It's all about experimenting. It's all about trying different things. So, for example, what I could do in this example here is I could take the slot and I could blitz him just like this right here. So I basically have Essentially, I have technically five men blitzing because my user is going to jump into coverage. So you always want to kind of start, in my personal opinion, with five-man blitz and then try to work backwards so that you try to see if you can, like, take more people out. So you'll see right here, again, as it shows on this little shadow guide, what I need to do is I need to run down and to the right. I don't want to run down to the left unless I'm standing over here. So if I'm standing here, this is where I want to run. If I'm standing over here, this is what I run and run. So we get based off of that research, it tells me that I want to go down and to the right, and what you're going to see is we're going to get instant pressure off of that left edge. So that is one simple little formula in which we can basically create our own blitz. So the next thing that I could do is I could, again, just kind of continue to take the theory a little bit farther. So what if I shifted my defensive line, and what if I crashed them out just like this right here, but then what if I stood kind of like right in here with my user to the point at which you see that I'm going to occupy a couple guys. As you can see, we still aren't able to get that pressure to come in because we're only blitzing four. So this is where we say, okay, well, we know it's going to be a five-man pressure. So what we want to identify is, okay, who are the five that gives us the best chance? In this example, it's probably blitzing both of the linebackers off of the outside. And so what you'll see now is if I kind of come up here into the gap, then what I'm going to do is just run down and off the left side. And what you're going to see is we're going to be able to get a free runner in at the quarterback based off of the little shadow blitzing technique that we're able to see here, the little shadows by the offensive linemen. If I shifted the defensive line to the left, you would see if I wanted to really, really overload that side, I could do something like this. But as you can see there, in my personal opinion, you know, every formation requires a little bit of a different shift. The beauty of the 3-3-5 wide is that you can kind of mix and match that. And that's why I wrote an entire ebook on the 3-3-5 wide. If you want to get that defensive guide, like I said, I'm going to leave a link to that in the description. But now let's shift for just a moment and let's talk a little bit about the big nickel over G. And the beauty of the big nickel over G, in my opinion, is that it can give you a position where it's very similar to like a 4-2-5 style of defense. So what I can simply do is by showing blitz, you see here I can basically create edge rushers on both sides. So then all I need to do is figure out where to stand with my users. So in this example right here, what I'm going to do is just pinch my line. And then, as you can see, it's based off where do I occupy. You see that if I'm standing here, it's the center of the guard. If I'm standing over here, it's the tackle in the guard. So if I stand kind of right in here, then the snap of the ball, I should be able to get pretty good left edge pressure. And as you see, we almost got a gap pressure based off of that. So that's some other thing. Those just continue to kind of build on one another, those little principles. You know, as to rules, there are few, but as to principles, there are, expressions of the principle, there are several, but as to principles, there are few. If you understand the principle, you see there, we can get that nice instant pressure off of that left edge with that big nickel over G defense just by simply standing in the right position. We don't necessarily have to be over the center, right? We could be a little bit to the left. And if we wanted to be over the center, we need to make sure, as you see from this shadow, that we're not stepping one step to the right. We need to make sure that we're over on this side right here. So it's just kind of very subtle things, but it is something that I think is very, very important. As you can see, the pressure comes in. We got nano detected right there, but the pressure is still able to get in. So thanks for watching this video. If you guys want to be the first person to know for whenever I release my big nickel over G defensive guide, I want to encourage you just to text the word Madden to 208-218-6900. And if you would like to get my nickel 3-3-5 wide defensive system, it's just $15. It literally walks you through step by step how to be elite defensively in Madden 21, from match coverages to zone drops to blitzes to run defenses to man-to-man theories. I would highly encourage you to check that 3-3-5 wide guide out. It's the best guide that I've released all season long, and I think it's going to continue to be the best defense in the game. So if you have not gotten the 3-3-5 wide defensive guide, I'm going to put a link to it in the description, and if you use that link, you can get the ebook for just $15. Thank you for your time. I hope you enjoyed this video.